How do you beat JJ? Philosophy. So, I'm here with Ramon in Ramon's garage where we've been training the past, I don't know, 4 or 5 months. And what I notice being in the garage or whether I'm in the gym with the guys is a lot of times after we're done rolling or after class, we'll talk philosophy, right? What just different types of, you know, techniques and how it applies, but also sometimes we go into real life stuff, right? So I wanted to talk a little bit of philosophy. So Ramon, I'll ask you, you know, when I say, how do you BJJ, what does that mean?
Yeah, so talking philosophy aspect, obviously, you know, you take what you've learned on the mat. I mean, how do you apply that to your real life? Because there's a lot of lessons that can be taught on the mat that can be taken out to real life that could really help you out, and have really, really, really helped me out over the years. And you know, having a couple kids, try to instill some of those in them. One of them that really is stuck with me and that I kind of try to live by and push onto them is being uncomfortable being comfortable with the uncomfortable. So what I mean by that is you know, if you're first starting BJJ, you're on the mat, you're getting choked, whether it be collar, armbar, pressure, whatever, it sucks and you're not breathing right, you're not thinking clearly, you're spazzing out, you're all over the place. Fast forward however many years, I'm in those same positions and I can literally just take a nap because I'm so comfortable because I've been in those positions so many times, I'm comfortable with it. I force myself to be comfortable with the uncomfortable by doing it over and over and over and over and over again, that now it's no big deal. So that translates, I think, a lot to real life. You know, there's situations you don't quite understand or you don't know, or you know what, I'm not really comfortable with doing this or taking this apart or cooking this meal. You know what, you practice over and over again, force yourself to do it, guarantee you, you force yourself to be comfortable with the uncomfortable, you're going to get really, really good at it.
That's good. I think one of the biggest differences between a white belt and a blue belt is just that, getting comfortable being uncomfortable.
Yep.
Right? And you see that in white belts to blue belts. You know, once they start getting to that level,
yep,
they're being smashed and they're in these bad positions and they're not reacting the way they used to.
Absolutely.
And then that, as you continually do that, translates, yep, to real life.
And the more comfortable you are, the clearer you can think.
Yes.
And then that can go into, you know, you're practicing for many years, BJJ, start getting into maybe some stand-up stuff, and then that takes you out to the street where you may be in an uncomfortable situation, but since you've been traveling so long, that uncomfortable situation is, you're comfortable with it because you've trained so much in the gym that you can handle yourself, which is a whole another series of videos, but same concept. It's just being comfortable with the uncomfortable.
Love it. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hey guys, I want to know how you BJJ. You can leave a comment below. Let us know if it's, you know, a long comment. That's fine. You can post a link. Maybe there's something that, you know, there's a video or something. You can post a link to that video. I'd love to see it. You know, I'm on a journey to learn. I don't even begin to know everything. And so that's part of the reason we're doing this. So thank you so much.